I think it's natural for people to say, why do you have 340,000 pickled reptiles and amphibians on shelves at the University of Kansas? This is a global collection of biodiversity. This is how we know what lives on this planet, is because of rooms like this. I think a lot of the credit early on has to go to Ed Taylor, our first curator of herpetology at KU. Ed was collecting, I think, for something like 60 years, and over that time described on the order of 500 species, collected thousands of specimens that are now distributed at biodiversity collections across the United States and across the world. But I think when I think about the program, I think of Bill Duhamel and Linda Truob as really being the people who started what we know now as KU herpetology. For me, the biggest part about the 100-year celebration has been learning about my predecessors here at KU, learning about all the students, the professors, the assistants, the undergrads, and hearing all their stories about what life has been like here at KU. Today, my colleague Rafe Brown and I focus a lot of our attention on our molecular work that's conducted here in our laboratory in the Natural History Museum. And it's provided a completely new layer of insight into biodiversity, having that molecular genetic perspective. Things that people wouldn't have even guessed or fathomed we're discovering with molecular genetic data now. Parents don't go to their kids and say, okay, you got three options. It's a doctor, or a lawyer, or a herpetologist. So we're in this unusual field. And the reason that all of us are here at KU is because we all have a passion for nature. And we all have a passion in particular for reptiles and amphibians. That's the thing that brings us together.